Hi all, Aditya here from JSoft Tech. In this session, we're going to discuss the project transport organizer. Prior to that, we'll also discuss about the system landscape and its overview for the BI team. And here, the first and the foremost thing that we need to understand is the system landscape, wherein we have various servers which are involved in SAP BI entire project. So here, we'll basically see three different servers which are very important. This is development server, quality server, and production server. And development server, all the developments like creation of a cube or DSO or any objects, all these things will be done in the development server. Those developments that we have done here will be moving to the quality, and in the quality, all these changes, whatever we have done, would be tested by the testing team. If it's approved by the testing team, all these objects will be moving to the production. So production is where exactly the client will be working. For example, if I normally take an example of IBM and BMW, if IBM is the company and BMW is the client, we are going to have all the BMW genuine data or the real-time data or the business data will be there in the production server only. Quality and development might not have this data. There is another server which is optional, which will be there in between development and production, quality and production, which is an optional actually. That is called pre-production server. Pre-production server will be introduced in a particular project only when the client wants to do the testing from their end. So if IBM is doing the testing in the quality server and BMW, which is the client, want to test it again, they will not be allowed to test it in the quality system. They have to go and do it in the production pre-production system, which have to be additionally maintained by that particular company. That's BMW. So SAP sells that server as well. Now here, as you see in the picture, it's very clear that the development, if there is a source system, ECC source system, and from development to development, we can get the data, or we can get the data from quality to development, or we can get the data from production to production. So we cannot get the data from development server of ECC to production of BI is highly impossible. Now basically, as I discussed in the theory part, most of the times the server name would be starting with some three alphabets, say for example CTS, and it's say 100. So CTS is the server name and 100 is the client name, client number. This is what normally happens, the naming convention of this particular client. So create package. So to put anything on the transport organizer, under the transport organizer, all the objects whatever we have done by default will be stored in a package called $tmp. $tmp is the file, is the package in which we'll by default have all these developments stored. And now what we have to do is we have to create a package in either SE80 or SE21, then save the package in a request. We have to save that particular package in a request. We have to create a new request. Then we need to go to the RS1 and transport connections and drag and drop all the objects or developments that we have done and save them in the package. Then again, create a new request, save and release. In the SAP BI system, first and foremost, we need to create a package. This package need not be created every day or every time. So once we created a package, it will be there forever, and we can store all the developments under this particular package. In this particular system, that's SAP BI 7.3, we just need to go to the package and create a package. The package name that we proposed is ZJHS087. Just say enter. It says the package does not exist. Do you want to create? Just say yes. The moment you say yes, it will show you the request number. So this request number, we are going to create a new request number now. and then we are going to save all our object, all that package, we are going to store it under that particular request number. Now we have to create this create. Click on the create. New request for SAP BI. You can give any description. Here. And once you just say okay, you can just need to save. Package is successfully created in SE80 transaction code. Now, once it has been created, we have to go ahead with the RS7 transaction. In the RS7 transaction, we just need to move all the developments that we have to move to the production. We just need to, you know, make sure what exactly is it, and then we need to go to the transport connections. In the transport connections, we just need to, you know, select those cubes or DSOs, whatever it might be, which you want to move, and just right click, you know, select that and drag and drop into the right side. So for example, let's say we want to select JH5, whatever developments we have in JH5, these things we want to just move it to the into the production. So we just need to right click here, drag it here, and then once it's been there here, save it. Now in this, we also want to move the info area and info objects as well, because info area and info objects also have not been moved to the in quality anytime. So we just have to move those definitions to also to the quality. So we just need to click on this transport objects. Once you click on this transport objects, it is going to be transported. So you have to click on this truck button. And then this is by default saved under $TMP. So if I try to save this, it says specify a transportable package. $TMP is not a possible. So what we have to do is we have to save it under this package which we have created in the SE80 transaction, that is ZJHS087. Now it will be saved successfully, and again a request number will be asked. So here we can create our own new request number. So for that, we'll just click on this new request again. New request for JH5 cube. Say okay. Then if this is successfully done here, then what we have to do is we have to go to SE09 transaction, that is a transport organizer, or SE10, and then we need to just move these objects from quality to testing to production, right? So for that we have to release. So for releasing, we have to go to SE09 transaction code. So these are the two request numbers which are there. So we just need to select this particular request number, release it, click on this truck button, and a tick mark will come here. Okay, so first of all, before releasing that request number, we have to release the task. Task is below this. So first we have to select this task, release it. For every task which is the, see, task is something which is under the you know, request number. Whatever is there in the under the request number is task. So now these are successfully, you know, released. Now we have to select the request number and click on this create, so that this will go ahead and you know, join there in the quality and production. Now it's been released. So it will come into the released side heading. Here it is modifiable, here it is released. Just that's it. So this is how we are going to, you know, release all the objects, and then transport people are going to move it from the development to quality, quality to production.